Warm welcome to an yet another video session on GATE papers. Today we are checking GATE 2018 Electronics and Communication paper, and the subject we are checking is network theory. There are actually four questions, and coming to the first question, the ABCD matrix for a two-port network is given as V1 I1 equal to ABCD V2 minus I2. We have to find the parameter B for this given network. ABCD parameter is defined as in the question, so we have to calculate B parameter is the parameter we have to check, and B is given by from the expression V1 equal to AV2 minus BI2, right? From that expression, we can note B equal to V1 by I2, right? Minus V1 by I2 at V2 equal to 0. Putting V2 equal to 0 in this expression, B turns out to be minus of V1 by I2. So V2 equal to 0. So we have to short circuit the output port, V2 equal to 0. So out of the four elements, that is V1, I1, V2, I2, now V2 equal to 0. So V2 turns out to be a known parameter. I am going to calculate first of all I2. I2 is the current flowing in this 2 ohm from bottom to top, right? From bottom to top. So the current I1 equal to 1 ampere is here, and it will split into this 2 ohm and this 5 ohm. So this 2 ohm and 5 ohm are connected in parallel to. So the net current flowing through this 2 ohm, that is I2 equal to, right, I2 equal to, the current direction is just opposite to I1. So minus I1 is 1. So minus I1 into, that is minus 1 into opposite branch resistance, that is 5, divided by total resistance in this parallel combination, that is 5 plus 2, that is 7. So I2 turns out to be minus 5 by 7. Now we have to calculate V1. For calculating V1 equal to I1 into the total impedance of this network, that is first of all we can calculate the total impedance, that is 2 parallel 5 plus this 2 ohm. So 2 parallel 5 is 2 into 5, 10, 10 by 7 plus 2. So that is again 10 plus 14 by 7, 24 by 7. That is Z equal to 24 by 7. And now V1 equal to, I1 is 1. So V1 equal to actually 24 by 7 itself. And now we can calculate that B. Minus of V1, minus of 24 by 7 divided by I2. I2 is minus 5 by 7. So cancelling this 7, B equal to 24 by 5. 24 by 5 equal to 4.8. Or multiplying both numerator and denominator by 2 gives 48 by 10, that is 4.8. 4.8 unit is ohm itself. So 4.8 ohm. So the answer is 4.8 ohm. Moving to the next question, for the given circuit in the figure, we have to calculate the voltage across this capacitor, right? So it is merely a series combination of R and C with the AC response, right? AC sinusoidal input response. So we have to actually calculate the voltage VC. Capacitor voltage is nothing, but it is actually the splitting of this input voltage phi sine phi t into this capacitor and this two resistance. So we can apply voltage division rule too. So VCT, that is the capacitor voltage, equal to input voltage VI of t into, I am marking the impedance of this capacitor as ZC, divided by total impedance, that is ZC plus the impedance of R, right? R includes both 100 kilo ohm and again another 100 kilo ohm. So substituting for VI of t equal to phi sine phi t into ZC equal to the impedance of the capacitor, that is 1 by j omega c. So I am substituting it 1 by j omega c divided by again 1 by j omega c plus r, right? So we can simplify it, phi sine phi t into 1 by j omega c divided by 1 plus j omega r c divided by j omega c, right? So we can calculate this j omega c and this j omega c. So VC of t, that is capacitor voltage, turns out to be 5 sine phi t into 1 by 1 plus j omega RC. Now we can calculate what is this omega RC. Omega is given as 5. So 5 into R is 200 kilo ohm. 100 kilo ohm plus 100 kilo ohm. So 200 kilo ohm. 200 kilo. So into 10 raised to 3. And the capacitor is 1 microfarad. So 1 into 10 raised to minus 6. So this turns out to be 5 into 200 is... Moving to the next question, consider the network shown below with R1 equal to 1 ohm, R2 equal to 2 ohm and R3 equal to 3 ohm. The network is connected to a constant voltage source of 11 volt and we have to calculate the magnitude of the current through the source. We have to calculate actually the magnitude of the current through the source or the current delivering by this source. So for simplification, I am first redrawing this circuit. So, checking this redrawn circuit, this is the direction in which current entering the circuit. And actually looking this circuit, this is, there is a 1 ohm, blue color 1 ohm, again another 1 ohm, and another blue color 3 ohm is there. On the right hand side again, that is 1 ohm, 3 ohm, and another 1 ohm is there. So this circuit is basically a symmetrical, a fully symmetrical circuit, right? Being a symmetrical circuit, if I apply some current through this circuit and the current will come this point and it will split into this point and this point and it will actually enter this 2 ohm this way and again this current, the same amount of current will enter this 2 ohm in this direction. So the net current flowing through this 2 ohm must be zero, right? The applied current will split at this 1 ohm and 1 ohm and will flow in this direction and will enter into this 2 ohm. Similarly, the current flowing through this 1 ohm will also split and enter this 2 ohm. The same amount of current will flow through this 2 ohm. So the net current must be zero. So as the net current is equal to zero indicates that there will not be any voltage drop, right? Current equal to zero indicates there is no voltage drop. So zero voltage drop is there in this 2 ohm resistance, right? Zero voltage drop. Zero voltage drop means we can actually short circuit this 2 ohm. Again, the same story will happen in this side also. Here also it is symmetric, completely symmetric circuit. So we can replace this 2 ohm by a short circuit. Now we can add this short circuit, this equivalent figure. So I am redrawing again this. So replacing the resistance R2 by a short circuit, it is as shown in this figure. So similarly, this side also, it will be a short circuit. Now we can check this figure and just checking this point, that is one parallel one, right? 1 ohm resistance in parallel with the 1 ohm. So I am marking it as one parallel one. Now checking this portion of the circuit, right? This portion of the circuit, that is one ohm parallel with the 3 ohm, again 3 ohm, again 1 ohm. So all these elements are parallel, that is one parallel three. Yeah, whole thing parallel with the one parallel three, again another one parallel three, right? And similarly at the last portion is again one parallel one, this portion, right? One parallel one. Now calculating the values, one parallel one, same resistance in parallel, that is half of the resistance, so it is 0.5 ohm. again here also it is 0.5 ohm. Now we have to calculate one parallel three parallel with again one parallel three. So one parallel three is 1 × 3 = 3/4. 3/4 parallel with again 3/4, so it will be halved, so 3/8. So this thing turns out to be 3/8. So total resistance equal to, right, 1.5 plus 0.5, 1 plus 3/8, right? So it is equal to 8 plus 3 11/8. So resistance turns out to be 11/8. We have to actually calculate the current. So current is nothing but is voltage by this resistance 11/8, right? So voltage is given as 11, so 11 divided by 11/8, so that turns out to be 8 ampere, right? So the answer is 8 ampere. So moving to the next question, for the circuit given in the figure, the magnitude of the loop current in amperes correct to 3 decimals 0.5 second after closing the switches, right? So it is a basically a DC response or DC characterization of the circuit, and it is an RL circuit. So nothing complicated with the circuits. So we know the basic charging discharging expression as IL, right? Inductor current equal to I final minus I initial into e raised to minus AT. So here I final is the switch will close at t equal to 0. The circuit remains as one voltage in series with the 1 ohm short circuited inductor and again another 1 ohm. So the net current must be 1 volt divided by total resistance. Final current equal to 0.5 ampere, therefore. So the final current is 0.5 ampere. Similarly, we can check what is this A equal to 1/time constant, but time constant is, here it is a RL circuit, time constant is L/R. So here R/L, A equal to R/L, right? So R equal to 1 ohm plus 1 ohm. So 2 ohm divided by L is 1 ohm. So A equal to 2. We can substitute all those things at this expression. I final is 0.5.